بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا مزيدا إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, we're all familiar with the term tawbah, when one repents to Allah. But there's another very similar term called inaba, a term mentioned in the Quran many times. And since it's Ramadan, we want to move from tawbah to inaba. Ibn al-Qayyim said, it's to hasten pleasing Allah while continuously and repeatedly returning to Allah at all times. Meaning it's tawbah, but continuous tawbah. Part of inaba is to retreat to Allah with your heart, with love, with reverence, with sincerity, in accordance to the Quran and the Sunnah. Just as one retreats in the last 10 days, i'tikaf of Ramadan, he does i'tikaf, leaving everything behind. Inaba is constant returning in i'tikaf to Allah. A heart needs to retreat to Allah, because if it doesn't do so with Allah, with honor, it retreats with humility to other than Allah. Turning fully to Allah in trials and at ease is inaba. A person who is munib is one who repents when he commits a sin, but goes further beyond that to change and becoming in constant contact with Allah, with a relationship with Allah. Allah said it about Ibrahim alayhi salam in Surah Hud, "Inna Ibrahim la halimun awwahun munib." Ibrahim was without a doubt forbearing, halim, invoking Allah with humility. That's awwah. And munib is repentant, constant, time and time and time again and again, constant repenter to Allah. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا. The most hopeful verse in the Quran. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. A verse considered by some of the ulama the most hopeful verse in the Quran. O ibadi, my slaves who have transgressed against themselves, transgressed, my slaves who transgressed, the ones who commit sins, despair not the mercy of Allah. Verily Allah forgives all sins. He's the oft forgiven and He's the most merciful. After repentance, Allah mentions wa anibu, what we're targeting. Inaba is three levels. The first level is the root of inaba, the principle, which is leaving shirk to tawheed, leaving kufr to Islam. Not having this will make one a kafir, because it's leaving kufr to Islam. That's the first level. It's taken out of the verse, وَالَّذِينَ اجْتَنَبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ أَنْ يَعْبُدُوهَا وَأَنَابُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فَبَشِّرْ عِبَادِ. The second level of inaba is the inaba of al-muttaqun, al-muttaqin, the pious, leaving sins and committing and doing deeds. Whoever doesn't have this one, he's Muslim, he falls under Islam, but we fear hell over him because he has sins, unless Allah forgives him. And that's taken out of the verse in Surah Ghafir, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا. In the following verse after, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ ثُمَّ لَا تُنْصَرُونَ. The third and final level of inaba is the level we're trying to target this Ramadan. The inaba of the muhsineen. The peak. Complete turning to Allah in your heart, in your body, constantly returning to Allah again and again, all times and all situations, being in complete submission to Allah. This is the best form of inaba. This is the inaba of Ibrahim alayhi salam. This was the level of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Inna Ibrahim la halimun awwahum munib. And it's also mentioned, wa ma tawfiqi illa billah alayhi tawakkaltu wa ilayhi unib. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, the people of this level are the most people tested by the shaitan, because they're the best, and the shaitan wants to get the best off track. Look at the master of humans, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the imam of all imams, the master of the repenters, the master of the worshippers, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, wallahi inni la astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayk kulla yawmin sab'ina marra. I seek forgiveness every day, in Sahih Bukhari 70 times, and then Sunan al-Nasa'i 100 times. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whose past, present and future sins are forgiven, and he repents and asks Allah for forgiveness between 70 to 100 times a day, how many is guaranteed that he's forgiven? How many times should we ask when we're not guaranteed forgiveness for one of the hundreds or thousands of sins that we committed? Sins harden the heart. So repent to soften your heart. It's a disease. ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةً. Even harder than rocks. Not even as hard as rocks. Harder. Sins darken the heart, so repent, so you can cleanse your heart. There's no better time than these blessed days. Allah said, كَلَّا بَرَّانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. That after that placed on the heart, it comes time where you need to wash it out. Awn ibn Abdullah said, there are those who are the ones who are constantly repentant to Allah are the ones you should always be with because they have the softest heart. Repentance is a great bargain with Allah. Look at the deal you strike. You make a mistake, you transgress, you repent, you correct your future, all your sins are forgiven, and a big baggage more. No one forgot to stock up this Ramadan on food and groceries, and if they did, they go prepare for it at Maghrib. But what about stocking on istighfar and tawbah and good deeds and repentance? Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, in azumat dhunubi kathratan falakad alimtu bi anna afwaka a'zamu in kana la yarjuka illa muhsinun fabiman yaludhu wa yastajiru al-athimu. Ya Rabb, in azumat dhunubi kathratan falakad alimtu bi anna afwaka a'zamu. Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, O Lord, if the greatness of my sin increases, then I know your forgiveness is even greater. إِنْ كَانَ لَا يَرْجُوكَ إِلَّا مُحْسِنٌ فَبِمَنْ يَلُوذُ وَيَسْتَجِيرُ الْآثِمُ. If only the righteous call you, then who would the sinners like me go to? أَدْعُوكَ رَبِّي أَدْعُوكَ رَبِّي كَمَا أَمَرْتَ تَضَرُّعًا فَإِذَا رَدَدْتَ يَدَيَّ فَمَنْ ذَا يَرْحَمُ. I call on you, my Allah, as you ordered and commanded, with humility, with reverence. And if you turn away my hands, then who else is going to accept from me? If you turn away my hands, then who else is going to have mercy on me? If you turn away my hands, then who else is going to forgive me? مَا لِي إِلَيْكَ وَسِيلَةٌ إِلَّا الرَّجَى وَجَمِيلُ عَفْوِكَ ثُمَّ أَنِّي مُسْلِمٌ. All I have is hope in you, Ya Allah, in hope that you will forgive me and that I am a Muslim. One of the most popular questions I get on this matter of repentance and inaba is, I repent, and then I do a sin. Then I repent, and I do a sin. Now I give up, and I despair. That's Allah's talking to you. Did you read the Quran? Allah's talking to you, calling you. Ya ibadil ladina asrafu ala anfusihim. Allah said, He didn't say, oh, you believers. He didn't say mankind, as many times in the Quran. He didn't say muttaqun. He didn't say the pious. He didn't say the muhsinin. He didn't say the forerunners, the sabiquna bil khairat. He called on the sinners not to despair. Asim ibn Raja said, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz gave a speech one time and he said, oh people, if you fall in a sin, then repent. And if you do it again, repent again. And then if you do it again, repent again, because the sins enclose on the next and they are destruction. And the peak of destruction, the destruction of all destruction, is remaining on sins, persistent on them without repenting. In authentic hadith in al-Tirmidhi, in the hadith al-Qudsi, O son of Adam, as long as you call on me, I shall forgive you of what you have done and think nothing of it. You're dealing with the Ghafoor. You're dealing with the Rahim. You're dealing with the Afu. O son of Adam, even if your sins were to reach the clouds in the sky and then you were to come and say, oh Allah, forgive me. If you say, oh Allah, forgive me, and you ask for my forgiveness, I would forgive you and think nothing of it. Ghafoor, Rahim, Afu. That's what you get out of the qualities of Allah, what you know about Him. O son of Adam, if you were to come to me with sins nearly as great as the earth, and you were to meet me after death, not making any shirk, I would bring you forgiveness as great as the earth, and think nothing of it. In Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Ibrahim ibn Shayban said, there was a 20-year-old young youth that he knew. The shaitan instigated to him that you're young. Why would you repent right now and leave the pleasures of this life? You got a life long ahead of you. So he went back to his sins in his old ways. In the midst of the sins, he had a flashback to his old days with Allah. A believer is still a believer. During sinning, he still has La ilaha illallah in his heart. So he yearned and longed and began to cry and weep for these days. He said, will Allah ever accept from me? Then he heard a voice. It's himself talking, possibly to himself. It says, you worshipped us, and we thanked you. You sinned and we gave you respite. You come back and we'll accept from you. عَبَدْتَنَا فَشَكَرْنَاكَ وَعَصَيْتَنَا فَأَمْهَلْنَاكَ وَإِنْ رَجَعْتَ إِلَيْنَا قَبِلْنَاكَ. If you repented and got fooled by the shaitan, return. Don't be ashamed. Don't despair. When you continuously repent, it's like a wrestling match with the shaitan. Every time you repent, you've pinned the shaitan down and won. You're the champ. Once you despair and stop repenting, the shaitan became the champ over, and you don't want that. Don't be surrenderous. Don't be strangers and accept continuing sinning and being on the wrong path. Resist and struggle the sins. Maybe one of your shouts to Allah in repentance will be so sincere that He will rate you among those swayed from being in Jahannam and take you onto Jannah. How can you think in despair in Allah with all these ayat and hadith? When He's asking you, why is He asking you to repent when Allah doesn't need me nor you? He's independent and sovereign. That's Ar-Rahim. That's Al-Ghafoor. That's Al-Afu. You're dealing with one more merciful than your mother. Wallahi Al-Azim. In Sahih Bukhari.